Hawkins' law is a practical correlation between changes in aggregate output and changes in the unemployment rate. In other words, the law is named after economist Arthur Melvin Hawken, and it is intended to tell us how much of a country's gross domestic product or GDP may fall when the unemployment rate is over its natural rate. Many economists have claimed that Hawken's law is a helpful guide for economic policy because it allows policymakers to improve the total output by decreasing the unemployment rate. In the year of 1962, Hawken presented two practical relationships relating to the rate of unemployment to the real output in his article, which has become connected with his name. Both were simple equations that have been accepted as rules of thumb since that period. Additionally, both have been developed by economists to include components that Hawken neglected in his study. We can express these relationships as 1. ET minus ET asterisk is equal to gamma into YT minus YT asterisk plus eta T, where gamma is less than 0.4. 2. UT minus UT asterisk is equal to delta of ET minus ET asterisk plus mu T, where delta is less than 0, where ET is the log of employment, YT is the log of output, UT is the unemployment rate, and asterisk indicates a long-run level. We can conclude Hawken's law substituting 1 and 2 as UT minus UT asterisk is equal to beta into YT minus YT asterisk plus epsilon T, where beta is less than 0, where beta is equal to gamma into delta, and epsilon T is equal to mu T plus delta into eta T. The coefficient beta in Hawken's law depends on the coefficients in the two relations that hold the law. The thought behind Hawken's law is simple. Output depends on the number of labor used in the production method, so there is a positive relationship between output and employment. Total employment covers the labor force minus the unemployed, so there is a negative relationship between output and unemployment. Hence, Hawken's law can also be mapped as a positive relationship between variations in output and variations in employment. The stability and importance of Hawken's law depend on how the long-run trends for GDP and the unemployment rates are specified. Hawken's law can be a useful guide for fiscal policy, but only if the natural rate of unemployment is correctly measured. It is unusual to call a macroeconomic relationship a law, yet Hawken's law has gained its name. It is not as common as the law of gravity, but it is effective and well built by the norms of macroeconomics. Reports of differences from the law are often misrepresented. Hawken's law is more reliable than other typical laws of macroeconomics. So if we have to answer the question, is Hawken's law a useful guide for economic policy? Our answer will be yes, but only to the degree that the natural rate of unemployment is correctly estimated. That was all about Hawken's law. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, Explified. Check out our channel for more interesting content.